Hello. Today I'm going to show you how to make these flowers. A few weeks ago I folded a few books and well, excuse me, I had a cold last week. I'm not very well yet. But when I'm ready with the book, I will put it down and, well, I decorate that book with a few flowers. And there was someone in the comments on that video where I did the book folding with a question if I could show how, if I could make a video of how I make these flowers. Well, I didn't invent these flowers. There are lots of videos on YouTube, but well, everyone has his own way and I have mine, so I will show you how I do it. What you need is, of course, book pages. I cut a few out already. And you need scissors, ruler, knife, and a cutting mat, or a cutting machine, of course. Sorry, someone came in my room with a question. Where was I? Oh yeah, a cutting mat, scissors, knife, ruler, glue, and some gems to decorate the flowers, the heart of the flowers, and of course book pages. And if you have a cutting machine, you can use the cutting machine. So what I'm going to do is cutting some squares. When you want big flowers, you make big squares. When you want, well, little flowers, you make little squares. Well, the squares I made in this case are, I think, 7.5 centimeters. Yes, you need for one flower like that, you need 5 squares, 5 petals. So here I have 5 petals. I have 5 squares. And what you are going to do is fold the square in half this way. Then this way. I will zoom a bit in. Yes, sorry, I have dirty fingers. This way, and the other side too. This way. What you're going to do now then is open this and do this. Yes. So you take one of those wings and you do that and squeeze it flat. So you have this. And you do it with the other side too. So you take that wing, squeeze it open, so, and voila. So you have this. Oh, yes. I cut these pieces
off.
Yes. That piece, I will cut that off. And I'm folding it like that. And this one too. Yeah. You take that one. So you have this. And then just bend it, not fold it, just bend it. So you have a petal. You take some glue and you can use a hot glue gun. Maybe I will do that because it immediately sticks then, and now it folds open again. So when you have glued that together, you have one petal. I will get my glue gun. Because this taking too long. One moment. I'm back again. I got my glue gun, so I will use that. So I'm going to fold petal number two. One, two. Just bend it towards another, so you have this. And I will put some glue between. Yep. Squeeze a bit. So. And that's petal number two. So I will use some glue too. So don't squeeze too hard, because you should not bend this side. So you can squeeze the here, but not there, because it has to be round. So now I have two petals. Do it once again. Fold it. So some glue between. And squeeze it. So, and now I have already three petals. One, two, three. Oh, two more to go. Petal number four. You hold that with two fingers, so you never can do this. So when you hold it like that, it always will go right. And you have a little line here, the fold line, the score line. And you can, and here you have a score line. So when that is towards to another straight, it's okay. So hold it, open it, that's the middle, just squeeze it till there, the middle, that fold line, just like that. Yeah, and trim the excess. So. So, that's a bit glue. And the last one. I'm getting the excess of the glue off with my finger. Well, you can do that, but glue is hot in this case. So now I have 5 petals. Now there are a few methods to assemble those petals, and what I like to do is take, I zoom a bit out, yeah, how do you call that, you eat meat, you can eat meat with this, satébreker we call it in Holland, but I'm not sure how you call it in English. But what I'm doing is taking one petal and glue, just a bit of glue on here. Take the stick, little stick, and glue it on. Just like that. Take petal number 2, a bit glue over there, and glue it to the stick on the same high, equal like the other one. So now you have 2. You repeat that with the other 3. Oh, I didn't glue that well enough. And That's three. Number four. Number five. So. And now you have your little flower. And what you can do is one moment, I will take a look for my gems. Well, I will take a blue one this time. So, here I have blue gems. And I will glue a gem in the middle. Just like that. Look. And that's your flower. I will make a few more and then I'm coming back with you. So I can show you how you can make something with more flowers. So I made another five petals. And I'm going to show you now how you glue them together without that little stick. So if you don't want that stick, you can do it this way. Put glue on the same way. But now you get another petal. And just glue it like that. But take another petal. Glue it like that. And the last one. Just glue it like that. It's a bit difficult to get the center right. Maybe there is another way, but well, it works. And you get a gem. I'll put a bit of glue here. Not with my glue gun, but just with tacky glue. Take the gem. And glue it on. So now you have a flower without a stick. when you have a book, one moment. What you can do is, and you have glued them this way, you could just, well, this is a bit too big, the stick. This is the short one. You can just take a place of look and just stick it in, and so you have the flowers on it, but it's loose. It doesn't well, it could fall out that way. So you have to stick it in again. Well, you can do it that way, but if you want to glue it, well, you better use not a stick, but just glue the flowers on the book. I don't know how exactly, but you can do it on there or whatever. So I prefer a stick. So you can stick it in, and that's okay by me, this way. Oh. So what you can do then is let's just glue the flower like that to the other flower. So I want some glue here and here. So you can a bit lower. Like that. Just like that. And glue it together. Just like that. And now I will make another flower. So, I made another flower. And I will glue this one here. You can, well, it's just a feeling. I think, yes, it should be here. So I'm going to put some glue there and there. Well, that should do. And just, how did I do it? That way. Just glue it in. So, now you have three flowers on a stick. And when you want to put them in a book, well, you can do it that way, but it's too big, it's too long. You see it, it's too long. So you have to cut a piece off. I will get, well, you can cut up that way, but you also cannot cut up that way. Well, I will do that way. It doesn't matter. It shouldn't be too long, that's all. So, yeah. I like that. Well, I hope you understood how I did it. And I hope you succeed too. Because it's... well, when you have done book folding, it looks nice on a book when you do that. But you can also put them in a vase, a bouquet. That's beautiful too. I'm back again. I decided to add some leaves to the flowers. And I will show you how I make these leaves. Very simple. When I cut those squares to make the petals for these flowers, well, these are the leftovers from the book pages. So what I'm going to do is take a piece of leftover, fold it in half or in two, don't know how you call that, but and then cut a leaf shape just like this, round, and I cut a few more big ones. And some smaller ones. So. And what you need is your scissors. Tweezers, sorry. And what you're going to do is, I will zoom in a bit. Yes. Take the leaf, then take the squeezers and put it like that and bend it. And you have to do it that way and bend it the other way. Bend it this way. So you get some of zigzag and so on. Yes, you are getting this. He does focus it okay, like that. Like that. And like that. Yes. So you have made a zigzag. Then, excuse me. Then you fold it open and you have your leaf. And you can glue it to the flower, just like that. Some glue on it. And you have a leaf. Oh, I'm out of focus. You glue on it. Hey, you glue it just like that. And this is the blue one I made. So I'm a bit out again. Yes, and I just glued three leaves on the back of the flowers. And this is the book. And I didn't use a stick here. I glued the flowers on the book itself. Just one flower with glue on it and just glue it on the pages. So you make these flowers without a stick. Or you can glue it on a stick, but just cut the stick off. You can do that also. And then glue it on the book. And I did glue leaves too on this book. See? Oh, you see a bit. Well, that's what I wanted to show you. Now I'm ready. I hope you enjoyed watching. Thank you so much. Bye.